could argue pop art's heyday is long gone, but for others, the artistic movement that appealed to many during the 1950s is alive and loved. Andy Warhol is probably the pop artist that comes to mind first. He'd crank out mass-produced pieces and often turn to screen prints, one of his signature styles.
The 50s. America was hip and clean, romantic and attractive. Advertisers were just beginning to learn that image was everything. In these post-war days of vitality and style, receding hairlines were far from happening. So when glamour-obsessed pop artist Andy Warhol found himself follically challenged, he took cover under a wig. But the story of the hairpiece is more than cosmetic. It became one of Warhol's and pop art's most defining objects. But Warhol really wanted to be accepted as a great modern artist. He found his big break in the kitchen. In Andy Warhol's studio, ordinary objects like soup cans and Brillo pads became pop art's calling card.
Pop art is an art movement that emerged in London and New York City during the mid to late 1950s. In a way, pop art was a reaction to the seriousness of abstract expressionist art. Pop art is meant to be fun, bright, and sometimes ironic or attention-getting. This form of art uses images and icons that are commonplace or popular in the modern world, hence the name pop art.
Guess which artist lived with his mom most of his life, was obsessed with Hollywood and ice cream, bald as a bat but loved crazy wigs, and loved to cover everything in aluminum foil? Yep, it's Andy Warhol. Warhol was born Andrew Warhola in 1928 in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, to Julia and Andre Warhola. Andy was moody, prone to panic attacks, and rather shy. After graduating high school, Andy attended the School of Fine Arts at Carnegie Institute. Even though he appeared weak and quiet, Andy would apparently outperform the other students in his art assignments. The quiet art ninja you never see coming.